In Bahrain, of course, they're still gunning down and killing those protesting for democracy. This week, a lady, middle-aged lady, passed away as a result of injuries inflicted on her by the use of poison tear gas by the brute dictatorship of Bahrain and their Saudi-backed supporters, including our own country, of course, and the United States of America, which continues to give arms and political and diplomatic support to a brutal regime that is killing the people in its own country for the simple act of asking for one man, one woman, one vote. This is a small country, and therefore the revolution in Bahrain is, as a proportion, the biggest revolution in all of the Arab world. Their demands are simple. One man, one woman, one vote for the government and the head of state. What right-thinking person could possibly oppose that? We have clouds, not just of poison tear gas, but of disinformation injected into that picture. Clouds of sectarianism, where the argument goes that because the clear majority of people living on the island are of the Shiite Muslim persuasion, that this somehow makes it a sectarian conflict. It doesn't. 99.5% of the people of Bahrain are not the Al Khalifa dictatorship. It goes without saying, all of them have an interest, whether they can yet see it or not, in the overthrow of that dictatorship, which controls and owns everything in Bahrain. Second, the British government, as was witnessed by the visit of the tyrant to Downing Street just in the last couple of weeks, is giving full political, diplomatic, and military and security support to the dictatorship in Bahrain, whilst waxing lyrical about other dictatorships, but only some other dictatorships elsewhere in the Middle East. The American government is not just backing this dictatorship, its entire Fifth Fleet is based on the island of Bahrain. Now you might well ask why they're doing all this, and the answer is the one that you yourself identified. Saudi Arabia will not be long in existence as a tyranny, as a dictatorship itself, if Bahrain becomes free. The reason that the British and the Americans have drawn a line in the sand in defense of the dictatorship in Bahrain is because they know that the overthrow of the Bahraini tyrants will hasten the end of the Saudi Arabian tyrants, to whom they sell uncountable amounts of weaponry, whose wealth from petrodollars they bank in their banks, put in their stock exchanges, have spent in their bordellos and their casinos, and in their arms bazaars. That's the big enchilada, Adam, and I thank you for bringing it to our attention once again. First of all, the GCC is in the Persian Gulf, right? But they've now allowed Morocco, on the very farthest corner of the continent of Africa, and Jordan in the Levant to join the Persian Gulf Cooperation Council. Go figure. When Iraq had its previous regime, the so-called GCC wouldn't allow Iraq to be a member. Go figure. It's the American forces who are in the so-called GCC area that are the cause of the instability in the area. You say, why should we allow foreigners to interfere? You've got the Fifth Fleet in Bahrain. You've got the biggest United States military base in the whole world in your member country of Qatar. You've got United States forces in so-called Saudi Arabia. You've got United States forces in the United Arab Emirates. And you've got foreign military ships patrolling in the Persian Gulf. And you say that there are foreign countries interfering in your affairs. You're having a laugh, Ben Bella. The point is, the intervention in Bahrain is an intervention not on the side of the people of Bahrain, but on the side of the dictatorship in Bahrain. That's why it's opposed by all right-thinking people and ought to be opposed by you. First of all, as I said earlier in another context, the police cannot investigate themselves, and neither can a dictatorship appoint a panel successfully to investigate itself. However, they did not get what they thought they had paid for. They did not get any implication of Iran in the events in Bahrain out of that panel. On the contrary, the panel specifically excluded any possibility of Iranian involvement in the revolution in Bahrain. And the panel did make some quite embarrassing comments and recommendations to the dictatorship, which is why we have not heard and will not hear any more about it.